गुड मॉर्निंग गर्ल।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग ममता।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर। गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग பெரிய சுவாமி।
குட் மார்னிங் மேம்.
குட் மார்னிங். ஒன்ஸ் தி செஷன் ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் நோ யூ கேன் ஸ்டார்ட் ஸ்ட்ரீமிங்.
ஓகே மேம்.
ஓகே பட் நவ ஒன்லி இஸ் இட் கனெக்டட்? நோ நோ
ஸ்ட்ரீமிங் மேம் இட்ஸ் கனெக்டட்.
ஹலோ யோகேஷ் சார். எஸ் 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 ஐ அம் சீயிங் தட். ஓகே சார். ஓகே சார். Start by sharp 11. I think card director is also ready.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. Is it okay, sir? I've seen somewhere. Okay. Once the director, Yogesh sir only hosting, no? Once the director sir starts, no? You can mute everyone, sir. Yeah, 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 sir. Basuraj, I do not know TP and TP. Principal sir has joined, sir. Yogesh sir.
Yes, madam. Principal sir has joined.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Jitendra sir is there. Yogesh sir, direct. ಪ್ರೆಸರಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾ? ಓಕೆ. ರೋಹಿತ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಮೇಡಮ್.
ರೇ ವೆಬಿನಾರ್ ಇದೆ, ನಂಗೆ ಒಂದು 2 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಮಾತಾಡಕ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾಯ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೆ.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್, ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಸರ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್
ಸರ್. ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬೃಂದಾ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸರ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಮೇಡಮ್. ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್, ಒಂಚೂರು ಮುಖ ತೋರಿಸಿ.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್,
ಮುಖ ತೋರಿಸಿ ಬೃಂದಾ.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್, ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಸರ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್.
ತಾಳಿ, ನನ್ನ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಬೇರೆ
ಹೋಗ್ತು.
ಕಾಣ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಕಾಣ್ತಿಲ್ಲ.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್
ಮೇಡಮ್. ಅದೇ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ.
ಹೌದು ಹೌದು.
77 ಜನ ಈ ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಲಾಗಿನ್ ಇದಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ.
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ. ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಒಂದ್ 10 ನಿಮಿಷ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀವಿ ಸರ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ.
ನನ್ನ ಇದು ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆ ಇದು. ಅದ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ನನ್ ಲಾಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲಲ್ಲ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ.
ಹೌದಾ, ಇರ್ಲಿ ಬಿಡ್ಡಿ.
ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹರೀಶ್ ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ಕೋಬಾರ್ದು.
ಲಾಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಅಂತ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಒಂದ್ಸತಿ ಲಾಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ.
ಅದೇನೇ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಡ್ಲ ಅವಲ್ಲ.
ಟಿಪಿ ಎನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸರ್
ಮೇಡಮ್ ಟೈಟ್ಲ್ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಿ? ಅಂತ
ಅಡ್ವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಸರ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಿದ್ಯಾ?
ಹ್ಮ್ ಹೇಳಿ.
ಅಡ್ವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಕೋಶನ್ಸ್ ಟರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಸರ್ ಯೋಗೇ ಸರ್. ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ
ಏನೇನು ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ಸಲ
ಸರ್? ಅಡ್ವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಕೋಶಂಟ್ ಅಡ್ವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಕೋಶಂಟ್ ಕೋಲನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಶಿಫ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಡ್ವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಇನ್ ಟು ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ.
ಓಕೆ.
ಮೇನ್ ಸಬ್ ಮೇನ್ ಟೈಟಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಡ್ವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಕೋಶನ್.
ಇಸ್ ದ ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆಂಟ್ ಕೋಶನ್ ಟು ಎಮೋಷನಲ್ ಕೋಶನ್ ಟು ಹೋಗಿ ಇವಾಗ.
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಅಡ್ವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ
ಸರ್
ಅಡ್ವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಏನು?
ಅಡ್ವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಲೈಫ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮೆನಿ ಚಾಲೆಂಜಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಸಮಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಅಪ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್, ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ವಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಅಪ್. ಬಟ್ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ಸ್ ನ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಸರ್. ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್.
ಬಂದ್ರ
ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಸರ್? ಬಂದ್ರಿ ಸರ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್. ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಜಿತೇಂದ್ರ.
ಆಮೇಲೆ
ಬೆಳಕ್ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಓಕೆ.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಸರ್.
Good morning.
Good
morning,
sir.
Good morning. ಈಗ ಅನೀಶ್ ಬರ್ತು ಅಂತ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಬರಲಾ ಹಂಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ? ಹಾ ಬಂತು ಬಂತಲ್ಲಿ. ಹಾ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇವಾಗ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಅಂತ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅದನ್ನ ಅಷ್ಟೇನಾ? ಮುಗಿದ ಮೇಲೆ
ಒಂದ್ ಲೈನ್ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬಿಟ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ ಸರ್.
ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ
ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್. ವಿ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಟು ಬಿ ಹಿಯರ್. ಐ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ವೆಬಿನಾರ್. Now I request Ms. Bhavana, our fourth eighth semester student from ISC department, to take over the session. Welcome, Bhavana.
Ma'am, a very good morning to one and all, distinguished dignitaries, HODs of various department, teachers, students, and lovely parents. I, Bhavana, fourth year ISC department, would like to welcome you all for today's on adversity quotient, shifting adversities into opportunities. Thank you all for joining us today. It is an honor to dignitaries and the guest speaker for today's event. I would like to welcome our beloved principal, Dr. Srikantha Murthy K, for this event. And I also would request him to please speak a few words.
Good morning, everyone. Dr. Yogesh, deans, HODs, vice principal, and my dear students. It is my pleasure to give the opening remarks here because we are at the challenging phase. As the topic says, adversity quotient, shifting adversities into opportunities, a right topic has been chosen by the conveners. So let me congratulate for them to choose this. And of course, the right topic is delivered by right person. And there is no other person who can deliver in a better manner than our Dr. Gopalakrishna. He is a very good orator. He is having a lot of skills and experience in this regard, because converting challenges into opportunities is in need of the hour now today. So I don't want to take much time because we have to listen to our director. Then students, I request to take away from this webinar lot of, so that tomorrow challenges you should be facing, because you are entering into professional life, it is very important for you to convert your challenges into opportunities. Opportunities sometimes may not come. You have to convert the opportunity into opportunities. So it is our pleasure to listen to Dr. S.G. Gopalakrishna, and I thank the organizers for giving me an opportunity to speak in this occasion. Thank you very much. All the best.
Thank you so much for joining us today, sir. Next, we have our Vice Principal, Dr. P. Harisha. I welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
We have our Dean, Academics, Dr. Jitendra Mungara. And I would also request you to please speak a few words, sir.
To whom you are asking? Harisha?
Dr. Jitendra Mungara, our Dean.
Okay. Yeah, thank you, Bhavana. Good morning to everyone. Respected Director, sir, Dr. Gopalakrishna, NIJ, Principal Dr. Srikanta Murthy, Vice Principal Dr. Harish and HODs, and conveners, particularly Dr. Mamata and Dr. Yogesh, and participants. It is a great privilege for me to be here today because our sir is speaking and delivering the lecture in full length. And this is the first time I'm going to hear SAR's lecture. And I would like to thank here at this point of time, Dr. Gopalakrishna sir about his area and the topic, the way how he selected. It's really fantastic. Really, it is very, very important topic, not only to the students, to everyone. This is that much of the importance is there on this topic. So the topic name is, as everyone is saying, that adversity quotients, shifting adversities into opportunities. It's really fantastic title. So basically, and human body is in an analog system, so each one is different in this nature. So micro level of the parameters towards this particular title, and the macro level of the components will be different at this point, on this particular title. But we cannot explain each and every one, but sir will take everything in detail in his talk. Basically, the contingent and environmental and dynamic situations, the adversary quotient is depending on all these areas. So in turn, all these three areas reflected in terms of intelligent quotient, emotional quotient, and adversity quotient, IQ, EQ, and AQ. Among all these things, AQ is really very, very important parameter in this regard. And there are four dimensions in this regard: control, ownership, reach, and endurance. Again, in turn, to deal with this, particularly AQ, that is adversities quotient, we have to listen carefully about the situations and explore personally or explore individually, analyze the personally, and implement whatever that you want to do. After doing all these things, definitely you are going to get the success in your life. So these are all the points are interconnected to come out from the issues. So this type of the things are going to tackle in this particular webinar. I hope that sir is going to give elaborate explanation about all these things. And I wish everyone should have the positive attitude, or gain the positive attitude, and keep the mind steady for the better things. And I hope that the audience are going to enjoy the webinar in detail about our SARS webinar, and the stuff is going to give, as the principal said, is a very good orator, and he will attract the people, any number of the people in the platform. Doesn't matter here. If once Gopalakrishna sir is speaking, everyone will become silent. I know that. And thank you very much. One example I wanted to quote, the people who are come across through this type of the things and who stood as an examples in this era. You take the Einstein, you take the Thomas Edison, you take the Richard Branson, and you take the Bill Gates. Those who are in the car from the last 100 years, the last three, and the Einsteins are and Edisons are, these are all the standing examples in front of us. So as I given these points, because I spoken this much of time, I took the 2 minutes or 2.5 minutes of time, because I like this title very much, and I love, because Sari is going to give the webinar on this topic, it's really correct and it is reaching to the correct people. So I wish all the best, Sir Gopalakrishna sir, and I wish all the participants to enjoy the time. Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to talk a little in this webinar. And also, thank you, Bhavana.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, I am done. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for joining us today, sir. Lastly, I would like to welcome our conveners, Dr. Mamta G., HOD and Director for Placement Department, Yogesha HC, Controller of Examination, and Mr. Periswamy, placements to this event. And for those of you just joining us, welcome to you too. Before we take this event further, I would like to put forward just two points. This event is being live streamed on YouTube. So for all of your audience who have any questions and queries, please feel free to drop in your questions in the comment section. And I promise that all of your questions will be answered at the end of the webinar. And the second thing is our feedback link will be sent at the end of the session. So please don't forget to fill it. I take immense pleasure in introducing and welcoming our guest speaker for the day, Dr. S.G. Gopalakrishna, Director, Nagarjuna Education Society. He was earlier working as principal at Nagarjuna College of Engineering and Technology, Bangalore from 2011 to 2018. Dr. Gopalakrishna is an outstanding and inspiring leader and mentor with strong interpersonal and influencing skills, motivating more than 20,000 students and staff members. During his tenure of service, he has helped various people to overcome adversities, be it students, their parents, or faculty members. He showed them the right path to overcome difficulties. We all love you here at NTT, sir. I am happy that such a versatile and dynamic person is here with us today. A heartfelt welcome to Dr. S.G. Gopalakrishna on behalf of NTT, sir. Welcome. And I request you to go over the session.
Thank you, Bhavana. First of all, I would like to congratulate and thank the organizers of this event, particularly Dr. Mamta and Dr. Yogesha, who are behind me in organizing this event. And I should also thank you for introducing me to the audience.
Thank you, sir.
Two earlier persons who have spoken, Dr. Srikanthamurthy and Dr. Jitendra, they have also spoken very nice words about me. I should thank them also. And the viewers, I wish you all the best viewing this webinar, particularly during the time of COVID. How this topic was chosen, the adversity quotient particularly was chosen because of the adverse condition that we are in. The COVID has made all our life with adversity. So therefore, we thought that how do we convert the adversities into opportunities? Can we have something on this? Can we highlight this to our, particularly our students and the other parents and the youth in converting their adversities into opportunities? So with this, we thought that we should have a topic like this, and we decided on that. I'm very happy to present this webinar about the adversity quotient, shifting of adversities into opportunities. Now, different quotients, all of us know that intelligent quotient, particularly, see, if somebody is good at mathematics, somebody is good at comprehension, somebody is good at reproducing. See, these are the intelligent quotient components. This, everybody will concentrate on this. The problem is, in the entire school education also, the intelligence quotient is given more importance by the parents as well as the teachers also. I think there is a need to shift this component. Intelligent quotient is one part of the story only. In order to be successful in life, every individual, every human being requires the other components of the quotient, namely the emotional quotient. For example, what is emotional quotient? How a person, an individual, will behave with his emotions. when he is happy, how he will behave. When he is unhappy, how he will behave. See, this kind of thing, how he will move with his friends, how he will have his emotions projected, controlled. In many cases, controlling the emotion also is required. So therefore, the emotional quotient comes as a next factor. The social quotient is another third component of the quotients. In the social quotient, usually what happens is how a person moves with the society. That is why the name social quotient has come. How a person will interact with the society, maybe a group of people, maybe a set of businessmen, a set of employees, all that, or even a set of friends. How do they move in the society? That gives the social quotient. Now, what is happening is the emotional quotient and the social quotient usually is downplayed by every individual. Everybody talks of the intelligent quotient. Intelligent quotient will give you result only if you have good emotional quotient as well as the social quotient. Now, coming to the fourth quotient, that is the adversity quotient. I am talking on the adversity quotient today. In any adverse situation, how an individual will behave, how he will respond, that matters. That will define the adversity quotient. And nowadays, in many of the companies also, employees are evaluated, their work is tested with regard to the adversity quotient. If they have high adversity quotient, then such people will get more and more benefits or higher jumps or promotions and things like that. That is how the assessment is coming into picture, but it is not in full swing. But in the days to come, I think adversity quotient also plays a very, very vital role. Now, if we say information versus knowledge, I have put here, the purpose is information all of us can get. For example, if you Google today, you get in your handheld mobile or any other device, you get the information. Information, just as it is, may not be of much use. The knowledge will be definitely useful. Here, I would like to quote some two or three examples here. Our earlier chief election commissioner, Mr. T.N. Sheshan, his example is he was traveling in Uttar Pradesh along with his family. And at that point of time, they were passing through a village wherein there was a mango grove, mango belt, mango trees were grown there. And therefore, there were a lot of sparrow nests in the mango trees. T.N. Sheshan and his wife and his family, they get down and they go to the mango yard. Then they see the sparrow net there. And T.N. Sheshan's wife requests for the net to be purchased. She does not want that to be given free, but she requests the other police officers who are escorting. He was the chief election officer at that point of time, and there was a lot of escort for him. The police officers who were escorting, they went and they saw one boy there. They called that boy and they asked that boy, can you give us two nests? We will give you some money for that. Initially, I think they said 10 rupees they will give for each net. Then the boy says, no, T.N. Sheshan feels that it may be too low a price. Therefore, he raised it to 50 rupees. He says, I will give you 50 rupees. You please give it. My wife wants these nets, sparrow nets, to be put in the house. But the boy says still no. At that point of time, police officers will ask, do you know who this gentleman is? He is the chief election commissioner of the country. And he is a big person. He is an IAS person. And you are saying no to him. Then that boy explains, see, if I give you that net now, there is small sparrows inside this net. Now the mother sparrow has gone for fetching the food. In the evening, when the mother sparrow will come back, it will find that these small sparrows are not there inside. The children are not there inside. So it will start weeping. I cannot see that situation. See what a kind of knowledge this boy is having on the environment. That T.N. Sheshan says, I did not take the net from there, and that bothered in my mind that whatever our education system is, whatever our qualification is, whatever our position is in the society, we should have some knowledge, some empathy towards all these other things also. That is how the information versus knowledge happened. Akshay Kumar is another example where he has stated in some of his interviews that he could not do well in his school education. That means the first part of it, school education usually will be with regard to the information flow. How much knowledge they enhance is again a question mark. All your question papers, all your other assessment methods will all lead to information, by hearting some things, by hearting some notes, by hearting some formulas. See, that way, Akshay Kumar could not do well in his school, and he had the passion for becoming a sportsperson. So he jumps up and says, I want to become a sportsperson. He goes and practices some martial arts and things like that, but he could not enjoy and he could not succeed there also. Then he jumps into modeling. Modeling, there also he was not very successful, but fairly okay. He could pick up some points there. And from there, he jumped to acting. There, he became very successful. One of the very well-known heroes of the day is Akshay Kumar. He is very successful. See, from how, what knowledge? If he, his parents would have told him to continue the school only and to go to the class and do some course only there, he probably would not have got successful in his profession. But now he has performed, he has just pursued some of the area where he is interested in. Now again, coming to Camphor Ball and Alum, see, this is again a case, just recently it has happened after the COVID outburst took place. In one of the apartments, there was a lady who was coming for taking all the waste, dry waste, wet waste, all that to collect and give it to the BBMP people. Now, while going, she says in the house, see, I have cleaned the entire house, floor, everything I have cleaned, all your vessels, everything I have cleaned. Now, after I go, you please keep some camphor ball in the house at some different points. This is what she says to the owner of that house. Owner was dumbstruck. He was thinking, all our education, where is it? She also continues and says, after collecting the waste from all the houses in this apartment building, I go back home and wash my hands with alum. Alum is a very good antiseptic which is used. So this actually, it is known by very other people also. See, when you travel across, supposing you are going to a high altitude, usually what they will do is they will give the camphor ball. If there is lack of oxygen and things like that, if you find a breathing problem, they give camphor ball. But this knowledge actually of applying that here during the time of COVID was taught by that lady who was coming for working in the houses. Adversity, there is a very good statement from Benjamin Franklin. He has said, in this world, nothing can be said to be certain. That means everything, except death and taxes, he says, that is only a continuation and a slogan. But nothing is said to be certain. That means there is a lot of uncertainties in this world. We all should be prepared to face such uncertainties. And how do we face all such uncertainties? Coming to the adversities. Adversities is again something which is not expected by any individual. So therefore, coming to the adversity quotient, the topic of the day, science of human flexibility. This actually, how do you adapt to a situation? How do you face that situation? How do you come over that situation? That is the flexibility that every individual should have. We should not be rigid with regard to our lifestyle, with regard to our working, with regard to our living. We should not be very rigid. We should be flexible. That is why the science of human flexibility is adversity quotient. It is measured like that. And every individual should also know how to deal with the adverse situations in a better manner. Here, I have given in the next point, AQ is extremely a powerful analyst of what all it analyzes. It analyzes the performance. Performance of a student, performance of an employee, performance of a business person, performance of a trader. See, all these are measured. It is a powerful analyst means these things can be measured in the adversity quotient that every individual should possess. Efficiency, how efficient your working is, how efficient you are in your living style. Learning, how much fast you can learn. Learn and unlearn, relearn. That is the concept. Learn, unlearn, and relearn. How much you are capable of doing that. Innovation, how new things can be invented and innovated. Flexibility in terms of the living, in terms of facing the situation, how flexible you are. You can't be very rigid. If you are very rigid, then a lot of other problems also will come. Depression will come. A lot of such uneasiness will be there in every individual. Therefore, we should be a little bit flexible towards our situations. Ability to encourage health and wealth. We see both health and wealth, they are very important. If you have good health, then wealth has some meaning. If you don't have health, then wealth has no meaning. So therefore, both your health and wealth, both are important. Now, to deal with the adverse situations in a better manner, this is what your adversity quotient tells you. Now, see, I told you about IQ, EQ, SQ. These three, out of that, IQ, everybody will concentrate on that and they are more worried about that only, improving that. Everybody should score 90% mark, 100% mark, 98% now, PUC. Everybody should score that kind of a marks. But by scoring that kind of a marks, will they be able to handle the failures in life? This is what needs to be attended to. Parents and the teachers should concentrate on, that is why, developing EQ and SQ. If we can develop EQ and SQ of our children, definitely their IQ has got some meaning, some better usage. So therefore, we should concentrate on that also. Now, for the adversity, I would like to give an example here. All of you know eagle. Eagle, it lives very happily for 40 years. It lives happily. It can catch any prey. It can feed itself. But during the age of around 40 years, its beak, the front beak, will start bending. It becomes weakened. So at that point of time, it cannot catch its prey. If it cannot catch its prey, it cannot get its food, it cannot live. So that is an adverse situation which every eagle will undergo. And it is an expected one, but eagle, see how smart they are. At that point of time, when the beaks get bent, at that point of time, they go to a forest, they will strike this beak against a very hard object like maybe a rock, maybe a big tree. It strikes against that and it tries to remove the beak. It will remove the beak and then slowly the new beak starts growing. When the new beak comes in, then after that, the eagle again can have its food, can have its prey caught. Everything will be normal for that. So it leaves for the next, again, another 30 years. That means out of the 70-year period that the eagle has, out of that, the first 40 years, after that, it will have adverse situation. So the adversity is overcome like that by itself, by removing the beak forcibly, though it may pain, but still it forces that the beak should be removed from the eagle, and then it will again grow. And that is how it will have a situation where adversity is there, the solution also it is thought. Now, there is a very famous story. This is a story of a brilliant boy. What happened is, there was a boy who did extremely well in the school education. He was scoring always 100 out of 100 in mathematics and 100 out of 100 in science and things like that. A very highly talented individual boy. And this boy grows and he did his education in IIT Madras. Then after completing his education here, he goes for master's in US and he joins University of California there. He completes his Master of Business Administration there, MBA, gets happily married, gets a job there, a very highly paid salary he gets. He joins there for a company and he starts working in US. He gets handsome salary. Life is very happy. He has married and he also has children. Then he buys one very good car for himself. Then he buys one big house for himself. Everything is fine. Everything is normal till the adverse situation comes in his life. At some point of time, his problem started. Adversity came to him. His salary got reduced. His income flow got reduced. Because of that, he could not pay the debts. And finally, he sells his house, he sells his car, everything he sells. But ultimately, even after that, he cannot live happily. So what he will do? Both of them, the husband and wife, they decide that we will commit suicide. And he shoots his wife and children also, and finally he commits suicide. What is the problem? Then California Institute of Psychology studied this case, and they studied, they met all his friends who were there, family members, his employers, office persons, all that they met, and they did some research on this. The worst part was the boy was prepared for only success. He was always successful. He was always getting good grades, good marks in the school, college, everywhere he was getting good marks, good job, everything success only, but he had never prepared for failures. The problem is our children should prepare for failures as well. The parent should note and see that children are prepared for failures also. That is why I have said here, the best success habit is getting trained for handling failures. Failures will come in everybody's life. That is why we call it as adverse situation. In everyone's life, this will come. But how we can handle that and how we can come over that, that is the most important thing that we should all learn. So therefore, parents should teach the children when there is some failure. Don't worry, keep up, you can get good score next time. See, all that. And the education system, again, is giving more importance towards IQ rather than towards EQ and SQ. Finally, the AQ. AQ also goes hand in hand. If somebody has got a very high AQ, they can be successful in their life. So the problem with that brilliant boy is finally what happened? Nothing remained. He committed suicide, entire family got lost. What is that? Then he was not prepared. He was not trained for facing the failure. Now, the other three examples I have given here, Thomas Alva Edison, you must be knowing this example. He had tested and he had done some research for finding out a manufacturing or making a bulb. But then he failed. But next time again, he tried. Next time like that. He tried many times, but ultimately he was successful. In one of the letters, I had seen that I have learned 1,000 ways of not able to or not doing a bulb, not manufacturing a bulb. That means all his failures, he had kept them. And you should not repeat whatever failure is there. It is a learning lesson. When that learning lesson is there, that's why we say failure is the stepping stone for success. Why do we say that? When there is a failure, if you can learn some tips out of that and try not to do that again, then success will be yours. So therefore, we have said that quote, failure is the stepping stone to success. Thomas Alva Edison is a good example of that. He had succeeded finally in that. Amitabh Bachchan, all of you know him. And during 2000, when the new century started at that point of time, everybody were enjoying, and Amitabh Bachchan had a very miserable lifestyle at that time. Because of the financial problem, he was not able to get good films for him. He was not able to succeed in anything. But at that point of time, I think Yash Chopra or somebody, they gave him a chance. And then he came into picture through the Kaun Banega Crorepati, KBC, what we call famous. He came through that. And when he performed well handling KBC, that attracted more advertisers. A lot of income came to Amitabh Bachchan. And finally, he could clear off all his debts. Entire loan what he had, he has cleared off all that. And finally, today, if you see, he has become a very, very successful artist, successful life person, successful family person, everything. So that means there was some adverse situation in his life. That time, he was in his late 50s. But today, he is a successful person. That is how he has converted his adversity into opportunity. His adversity itself. See, one of the bank, I think, had come forward to auction his house also in Mumbai. But finally, what happened? He could clear off all the debts and be happy. Lakshmi Agarwal is another good example. Lakshmi Agarwal, during her school days, maybe at the age of some 15 or 16, I think she was attacked by some people with acid. So she was a victim of the acid attack. And the reason for that, very, very silly reason it was, one of her friend's brother wanted to marry her. And she refused that I will not marry him. For that boy, even he also could be around 18 or 20 years of age at that time. He has come and he had thrown acid on her. What a tragic situation was there for her. She could not show her face. Everything was damaged. She was literally suffering. The physical suffering what you have, the mental suffering, the mental pressure what she had, everything was tremendous. But Lakshmi came out successfully, and she could get everything done with all plastic surgery, everything. She became normal after maybe 2 years or 3 years like that. She underwent a lot of trauma and torture, but ultimately she came out of all that. And then now she has started an organization to help the acid victims. This is something interesting. She is now helping all these acid victims. She calls them to her enterprise, her organization in Delhi, and then she counsels them, she trains them, she gives a lot of moral courage, encouragement to all those people who are depressed with the acid attack. So therefore, she has found an organization. She has come out of that. See, this is the story of Lakshmi Agarwal. And They are also coming out with a movie now for the acid victims story. They are coming out. I think it is shortly going to come. See, this is how adversity will be there. But how do we come across that? How do we overcome that? And how we can be successful? That matters a lot. Now, Sushant Singh is the recent example. What happened is, I think during the lockdown or immediately after the lockdown, this gentleman, he committed suicide in Mumbai. A very good actor. He had acted in a few serials, TV serials and films. But see, he was a brilliant boy. Again, what we feel is when this incident has happened, when he committed suicide, what we feel is his IQ level was very high. But his EQ, SQ and AQ level was not that high, particularly the AQ level. The adversity quotient, when there is an adverse situation, when somebody will blame you, when some group will blame you, at that point of time, how do you take that? How do you convert that into your positive thing? See, that again, adverse situation, he was not able to overcome that probably. And because of that, Sushant Singh committed suicide. So there are plenty of such examples where both the adversity faced and success, that is why on the left side I have shown them with green, they were all successful overcoming the adversity. But on the right side I have shown with red that he was not able to overcome the adversity, adverse situation he was in. Handling adversity is coming to the point. See, every individual should focus on the strengths. And ultimately what happens is, everybody will have some limitation or the other, but you should understand what limitation you have. If you can understand what is your limitation, then you can overcome that limitation as well. And focus on your strengths. When you focus on your strength, you can be successful. Because that is the one which will give you moral stability, moral strength. Whatever you feel, supposing you are good at sports, if you are very good at sports, you can focus on that. Yes, focus on the sports and get along with that and be successful there. Whatever is your limitation, overcome that. And handling adversity is, again, the internal locus of control. Every individual will have the internal locus of control. One important thing that we should understand is, in many cases, in the adversities, we will not have a control over the situation. The best example is the COVID-19 example. Does anyone has the control of the COVID-19? No, the situation is existing. You don't have a control on that. But what you can control is, your internal locus has got the control. You can do, you can overcome that. All those points, whatever people are doing now, whether it is wearing a mask or whether it is not coming in public, going to crowds or maintaining social distance, hand sanitizing, so many other issues. Okay, all those things you are doing additionally, if you can do some exercise for yourself, your body also can be fit. So, one example only I have given. So, internal locus of control is very important. Everybody should understand that we don't have a control on our, on the situation. We don't have a control. Then, we have to identify the adversity and its outcomes. We should understand that. See, when you understand the adversity, you are the better person to take the solution. You are the better person to decide the path of action. Then you can act. If you don't identify and understand the adversity at all, then you will not be able to take the outcome. You will not be able to have a better outcome. So therefore, initially you need to identify and understand the adversity. Then partnership with friends, counselors and teach. See, this will give you some kind of what I should say, strengthening the adversity quotient or including the strengthening of the social quotient as well. You are moving with friends, counselors. You see, whatever problem you have, if you can highlight that. If the adversity is individual adversity, that's a different story. If the adversity is a mass adversity, then everybody in that community should take care. So therefore, individual adversities, there could be individual adversity as well. See, I may take an examination and I may fail in one of the exams. That is the individual adversity. But when I talk with my counselors and teachers, they will guide me and they will tell me how I should prepare for the exams and how I should fare well. That way they will prepare us so that I can prepare well and next time I can get along. I can clear that paper. That is how individual adversities can be overcome. But en masse, like situations like COVID, for example, everybody should join hands. That is where you need to discuss with your counselors, teachers, everybody, and take suggestions and improve upon that. Involvement in a meaningful community project. This is very important. See, if you can involve in some community project, that gives you some kind of satisfaction. See, we say success is measured by others, whereas the satisfaction is measured by within. We measure our satisfaction. Others will measure our success. So therefore, this distinction we should understand and we should be satisfied. Therefore, in order to get satisfaction, if you can involve in some community project, whatever project it is, see, going to a school and teaching some children there, school children there, that is a community work. If you are intelligent, if you know some knowledge about some subject, you can go and teach the children. That can be a community project. See, community projects can be varieties. It can be developing a social planting or maybe water conservation, highlighting in rural areas or giving them some kind of exposure to the digital banking system, all that. Okay, community project could be anything. If you can involve, thereby you develop some positivity in yourself. And you will also get the satisfaction ultimately. You feel that I have helped these people. So that is the contribution that I have given. So thereby, you can definitely overcome the adversity. Always thinking on the adversity itself will lead you to depression. Therefore, when there is an adversity, you think on that sometime. Then after that, identify what other alternative paths are there, what are my actions, that what I should take, decide on that and involve in some community project. Thereby, you can just simply overcome that adversity. The other point is positive thinking. Everybody knows that we should all think positively. In any situation, we should not have any negative thinking. We should always be positive in our life and in our approach. When we are positive with our approach, definitely things will improve. The best example is the shoe salesman example, wherein two salespersons were sent to some village to identify and do the sales there, executives. They go there, one will immediately send a mail saying that here in this village, nobody is wearing the shoes, therefore there is no market here. We cannot have our product sales here. We cannot sell our shoes and other products here. Therefore, it is not possible. The other person will send a mail saying that nobody in this village is wearing the shoes. Therefore, we have plenty of opportunity. We can sell the shoes. We should conduct a lot of advertising and marketing activity here. We can sell our shoes here. There are a lot of people who are without the shoes. Therefore, we have great opportunity. See, look at the situation is same, but the concept is being looked at two different people in two different ways. One is a negative approach, the other one is a positive approach. So therefore, we should always be positive in our approach. This is another example where a teacher gives a question paper in a class and every student was asked to write a note on this question paper. The question paper, everybody wrote, it is, see, a plain sheet of paper, white paper on that. There was a dark dot at the center. Everybody wrote about the dot. They were saying, this dot is of this size. The dot is exactly situated in the center. The dot is a dark dot, black color in color, and things like that. They were explaining about, every student was explaining about the dot. Nobody explained about the white paper, which is huge and which is empty. The space is empty. See, this is what, again, the negative thinking. Small dots, there will always be small problems, small issues. Don't worry about that. You look at the larger life, larger part of your life, larger part of your success, be happy with that. So you should always look at the larger side of that. That is why I have given this example. E plus R is equal to O, I have given this equation. See, this is the adverse situation. Events, E stands for events. Events, on the events, nobody is having the control. Usually, you cannot have the control on the event. But what output you want, you can determine what output you want. So the output that you determine can be accomplished by the response that you create. So event is there. You give a response for that. Thereby, you get the output. The best example is the India-China conflict, border conflict. That is an event which is occurring. So nobody is having the control now. We cannot have any control over that. Our government cannot have any control over that. But that event is happening. Now, for that event, the output should be a smooth one. So how war is not the solution? If war, if we say that is not the response, but it is the reaction. See, event is there and R can also be termed as reaction. If you do the reaction, then the output will be very bad. But if you respond properly, the output can be good. The response could be going to the neighboring countries, taking their help, buying and some equipments like this, putting a lot of such efforts, negotiations, conducting a lot of negotiations, they all form the part of the response. So therefore, events on which individuals do not have control, the response that you give will lead you to good output. We should all think of this and go for good output. Now, coming to shifting of the adversities into opportunities. See, adversity is not a permanent thing. It is a temporary. See, for example, I gave you the example of failure in one subject. So failure is temporary there also. The next attempt I have, I can clear that paper. Therefore, adversity is temporary. It's not a permanent one. Anything you take, even the COVID example that we give, you take this example also. COVID is going to stay with us, but the adverse situation is not going to stay. Initially, what we had, now what we have, the control what we have, the measures that we what we take, every individual will contribute. Depending on that, it is a temporary situation. Maybe after 1 year or 2 years, when there is a vaccine for that, probably that adversity will vanish and we will all be happy. So therefore, adversity is temporary. Now, adversity is an anchor I have told here because, see, one of the ways is, I can give you this example, the seesaw example where the fulcrum point is at the middle, then it is perfectly balanced, no adverse situation. If you move the fulcrum to the left or to the right, then there will be unbalance. So adversity will happen. Now, in any situation, if you have to come over the adversity, then you have to move the fulcrum away. You have to move the fulcrum towards, supposing you are on the left side, you move the fulcrum to the left side so that your effort becomes more. But if you move the fulcrum away from you, then your effort can be less. The mechanical advantage will be more. You put little effort, then also you can be successful. Thereby, I feel that this anchoring needs to be looked into in the adverse situation. Adversity is a great teacher, yes. It has taught a lot of things. For example, the webinar that we are conducting today, it is again, the adversity has given us this opportunity. The students are listening to the video lectures and the digital technology, online courses, online teaching, all that has come to the forefront today. So it is a great teacher. It has taught us some life skills. So therefore, that is the greatest teacher, adversity. Adversity reveals the good. Yes. When the adverse situation comes in, at that point of time, you will have the analysis of the good and bad. And it reveals the good one, because you are overcoming the adversity, and thereby you are just simply passing out like that. Then you have to practice gratitude. I told you about activities that you can involve in some social impacting activities, some contribution like that. So you have to practice gratitude. Coming to the positive thinking, see, life is not always perfect. There is always a possibility for a problem. This is what I told you initially. The adversity can come in our life at any point of time. It can come today, it can come after 1 month, 1 year, 2 years, 5 years down the line, anytime. But how do we look at the problem? The problem is not the end, but it is the beginning of a different life. See, this example gives us, when the pencil is cut, if we can sharpen both, it makes two pencils. Thereby, we are looking at the problem in a different way, the positive way. Again, this is a statement by Dr. Abdul Kalam. If you want to make some juice, then grapes are to be pressed. If you want to make the perfume, flowers are to be pressed. Therefore, what the net result is, if you want to bring the best out of you, then naturally pressure will be there. Pressing in the sense, it is the pressure, the life pressure that you take. So every individual will have such pressure, and you need to take it in the true spirit, because ultimately the flowers are the grape. They have given us juice and fragrance. Similarly, you also give good fragrance to the society. There will always be some criticizing people around you. But one very important thing that you should remember is, in every game, the audience only will make the noise, not the players. So therefore, you be a player, believe in yourself. This is very important. We should believe in ourselves, then we can be successful. We are all the players, and don't worry about the audience. Don't worry about what criticism they make. Don't worry about the people around you who make criticism. See, the same thing happened in Lakshmi Agarwal's case. Everybody, they were criticizing. They were saying, it is the problem with Lakshmi. Why did she refuse that gentleman? See, if somebody is not happy marrying a boy, then refusal will come. If refusal itself is a problem, if people start criticizing that itself fundamentally, that's not correct. So therefore, criticism will always be there under any situation. There will always be criticism. But you need to overcome that, and you need to be a player in your life. Believe in yourself. That's all. You will do best. This is another example I would like to give. Arun Lal, everybody knows, he's a famous cricketer. And right side person is Bikas Chowdhury. Bikas Chowdhury's father was a laundry person. He was coming to Arun Lal's house every now and then to press the clothes, to wash the clothes, to take the clothes and things like that. But at that point of time, Bikash also used to come sometimes to hand over these clothes and things like that. And Arun Lal's wife, she started teaching Bikas Chowdhury about the school education, the chapters, everything. She became his teacher. And she started teaching Bikash. Finally, he was very successful in school. And today, he's a big entrepreneur, big industrialist. And see the simplicity of this Bikas Chowdhury. He has donated one Mercedes car to Arun Lal. He has helped Arun Lal now at this point, at this age. He has helped Arun Lal in many ways. That is how the humanity comes into picture. See, during his younger days, he was helped by Arun Lal and his wife. They had taken care of his school fees, everything. Finally, after becoming success, after getting success, he has helped these people. That is humanity. Again, for the humanity, this is another best example what we could quote. This front person is Abel Mutai. He is a Kenyan athlete. And the black person in green trouser, green t-shirt is Ivan Fernandez. He is a Spanish person. He is from Spain. This person is from Kenya. What happened is in a race, this Abel Mutai was about to complete the race, but at that point of time, he thought that he had already completed. He mistook that sign, what was presented there. He mistook that signage and he thought that he has completed the race and he slowed down. And Ivan Fernandez, look at the humanity and the sportsman spirit that he had. He pushed this person to the end and he said, you complete your race first. He could not understand Spanish also, this Abel. But still, that's why when he could not understand the language, he pushed him literally to the winning point. And afterwards, Ivan Fernandez was questioned by the press people. They asked him, how did you do this? You were about to win and you have pushed Abel to win. Why did you leave that race like that? Abel says, Ivan says, how do I face? See, he was all, after all, he was the winner. He was the winner, but I allowed him to go there. Yes, Abel. What should I answer to my mother? If she asked me, where is my humanity? Therefore, I allowed him to complete the race first. Anyhow, he was the winner. See, humanity plays in different roles, in different occasions. Again, for humanity, I think in Norway, they have this system. People can go to the coffee shop or restaurant and they can buy 5 coffee and 2 suspended out of that. That means literally what will happen is 3 coffee will be taken by them and 2 suspended coffee will be there with the canteen or the hotel person. Any beggar or any person, poor person who wants to use that, they can come and ask for suspended coffees, suspended meals. That way, see, one important point here is the person who buys the coffee, 5 coffee, he will pay for 5 coffee. He does not know who the other 2 coffees will go for. Without knowing the face, without knowing the person, the other 2 coffees are donated. It is not just the coffee, it can be the meal, it can be anything like that. They do this system. What a humanity it is. Here also in Bangalore, they have brought some fridge for the leftover food. Again, this is another type wherein a fridge is kept on the footpath and people who have some food left over in the house, they can bring it and keep it there. Whoever is hungry, whoever is poor, they can take and they can eat that food. This again is a better example for the humanity. Patriotism. Everybody should have patriotism. And Mikhail Gorbachev example is, he has stated this in some of his interviews. When Mikhail Gorbachev was studying in Europe, at that point of time, he had 2 classmates who were from Japan. And Japan, as you know, at that point of time, it was Hiroshima and Nagasaki, all that bombing, everything was there. And because the World War, Japan was suffering too much. And they were not in a position to even produce goods of quality. These 2 people, the classmates of Mikhail, they were writing the notes by turn. One used to write the note, the other used to mend the pencil. Look at the situation. That is how the Japanese product was. The pencils were not of good quality. Many of the European classmates also, they were saying, these Japanese students, why don't you buy some good pencil from Europe? These Japanese students said, see, if we start buying Europe product, who is going to buy our Japanese product? See, what a patriotism they have. Fantastic. And that kind of commitment has converted Japan into a very, very top country in terms of quality, in terms of products, in terms of economy, everything. Beautiful. Now, coming to the closing remarks, everybody should understand that no one is perfect. Everybody will have some nuances, some kind of adversity, some kind of problems, some kind of deficiencies, some kind of weakness. So you cannot expect that you be a perfect person. So therefore, what we should do is, everybody will not be perfect, but whatever perfection that we can bring in, whatever efficiency that we can bring in, whatever effectiveness that we can give, we should give. The output we should give. And each day is a stepping stone in our journey for a better chance to get a little better. So everybody should get better every day. Now, for example, the COVID situation, if you take, we had a lot of bitter experiences, many people died, and even today, the vaccines are not there. That is a stepping thing now. So vaccines will be invented. They have taken top priority of that. Now, PPE kits were not manufactured in country. Now they have started manufacturing 2 lakhs or 3 lakhs per day. See, that kind of a change. Good has happened. The adversity will also give you a lesson for better. So you need to change for better. With these, I wish the audience all the best. And if there are any questions, I think I can take the question. Thank you all. Be safe. Stay safe.
Thank you so much,
Bona?
Sir.
Yes.
Thank you so much, sir. It was a very eye-opening event. I think this was the need of the hour right now, considering the pandemic and cabin fever that people are going through. This very helpful. Thank you so much. We do have a few questions from our lovely audience. The first question is, how can students, particularly youth, overcome adversities or failures?
I would like to give here one or two examples. Now, one of the best example is the story of a positive donkey. See, wherein there was a donkey with a farmer and it was old. Now this donkey, one day it fell into a well, open well, it fell into a well, and the farmer thinks it is very difficult to take it out. Anyhow, it is aged. It is already old, therefore I don't have to pick it out, and he leaves it there. He had plans of filling up the well with mud. So he calls some of his neighbor and starts filling up the mud. See, that is a very adverse situation for the donkey. Now the donkey fell into the well. Now people have started filling dirt and mud into that well. So the donkey thought that I am going to die now. At that point of time, when some dirt or mud was filled in, at that point of time, this donkey will just shake its body and get up and come over that dirt. Every time the new dirt is filled, the new mud is filled, this donkey comes up like that. Finally, when the entire well was filled with mud, this donkey is again back to the ground. That is how the adverse situation what was in, that is converted to a opportunity. It converted that into an opportunity and it became successful. So students will have adversities, but we should think in our life. That's what I said. Every time there will be some kind of adversity or the other. The failure, for example, in any subject or a course, if some student has failed, that is, of course, they should think that it is a learning exercise. I'll learn more about this subject. I'll become the master of that subject. That way, you should put more and more effort on that and complete that subject. Academics, of course, you cannot neglect academics, but ultimately, academics itself is not the end. Please, we have to understand that. We should develop all our other skills also, and we should do it. Now, I will give you three examples here. One, we can say that the best way to overcome the adversity is you fight with that. See, corona came. You say that, you see, you fight with the corona. That means you say that you prepare yourself. You say that corona will not come to our house. Corona will not come to me. Corona will not come to our locality. See, all that is fine. But will it matter? Fighting against that, will it matter? No. Events are not under your control. Only the response is your control. The output you can define depending on the response that you give. So when you fight, if that is not going to help you out, then the next point is you should take the flight. That means, can you run away from the situation? The best example is, I told you about the India-China border case now. Can you run away from the situation? No, you cannot run away. Where it is possible, of course, that could be your alternative. Supposing you are in the forest and some elephant or a tiger will come in front of you. If you can run away, fine. That is an adverse situation where you are in, but you can run away. Okay, that's possible. But in a life where you are studying or something like that, you cannot run away. You are asked to come to a seminar and you don't like to go there to the seminar. Therefore, you argue with the teacher, no, I will not come to the seminar, but instead I'll write this assignment, I'll prepare myself for the exam, all that you say, fine. That is fighting, not going to the seminar. Then if the teacher says, you have to come to the seminar, then what you will do? You have to go to the seminar. Otherwise, you cannot run away. So flight is not possible. So fight, flight, the third one is, F is flow. You flow with the situation. So, if you have to attend the seminar, okay, go and attend. You flow with the situation, go and attend the seminar, but attend the seminar with pleasure, not with pain. If you attend the seminar with pain, then naturally only bad things will come in. But if you can attend the seminar with all your positive thinking, okay, I will utilize the timing, I will gain some more information, more knowledge on this, that way, then definitely it is going to help you. So you have to have three F and one P, fight, flight, and flow. And the output is pleasure, with pleasure. The same thing can be said in three B's. Three B's are broken. Initially, it is broken. Then bitter, the situation could be bitter. Then the third one is better. See, COVID, for example, I'll tell you, students could not come to the class. They are sitting in the house and they are studying now. It has given us some new avenue, some new learning, some new good thing has happened because of the COVID. So we should always look at that positive sign, positive thing, and then we should come over the problem. This is how we should face the adversity in one's life and come over that.
Thank you so much, sir. I think your question was answered very well. The second question is, how do we balance IQ, EQ, SQ and AQ equation optimally? And is it possible to have a low IQ and EQ but have a high AQ?
I feel, yes, it is possible. This is exactly what I said. Many of the teachers and the parents, they are more concerned about the IQ only. Everywhere they see your marks card, your grade card, that is the only thing what is seen. That point should go away. That means importance to EQ, SQ and AQ should be given. More importance if you give to AQ, and less importance to IQ, people can be successful. Definitely you can be successful. The balancing of that, what the question is asked, the balancing, it may not be equal 25% you have mathematics. No. IQ, you should have a little bit of IQ. Even if you have less IQ also, you can be successful. Definitely you can be successful. You may not complete that paper. You may not complete that examination. That's not the end of it. Without completing the exams, we have many examples like that wherein people have become very successful without going to the school. Steve Jobs, for example, he was sent back by the teachers saying that you cannot study this mathematics, you cannot study this, that, you go back. His mother taught him. And what happened ultimately? See, formal education is one part that will give you some little bit of IQ part of it. But the other things like EQ, SQ and AQ in particular now, AQ should be developed by the individuals. Therefore, the help of counselors have to be taken, the help of teachers have to be taken, the help of friends have to be taken. Then, if you build up your AQ well, I think survival and flourishing in the world is not a big task at all. You can be successful, definitely. This is my opinion.
Thank you, sir. We have one last question. Who is your role model who has perfectly overcome adversities and turned it into opportunities?
As such, I don't have one role model. That's why I have mentioned many people here. It could be Amitabh Bachchan. It could be Lakshmi Agarwal. It could be anybody like that. We have taken so many examples. I think adversity. See, this is what we were debating. Individuals will be successful. They will be successful. Successful people will be our role model. But whether they had any adversity, yes, it's a big question. See, Abdul Kalam, for example, in one of his interviews, he had told that, see, when they wanted to test some PSLVs, he was the project director, but they could not succeed the first time. When he was not, he had not succeeded at that point of time, I think Mr. Satish Dhawan came to the press meet and said, we have failed in our venture. He took the leadership and he took the responsibility. We have failed in our venture. But ultimately, we will prepare and come out successfully. The next time when success came in, at that point of time, again the press meet was there. And Satish Dhawan asked Abdul Kalam to conduct the press meet. Look at the way. What a magnanimous attitude he had. Satish Dhawan, a true great leader. I think we have many such role models. Abdul Kalam could be quoted. He too had some adversities like this, but he has overcome that.
Right.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for taking the time to be with us today and to also answer the audience questions. Now, I would like to wrap up this session with a vote of thanks. I, on behalf of NPP and the organizing team, on behalf of Dr. Mamta G, Dr. Yogesha and Mr. Periswamy, and on my own behalf, extend a very hearty vote of thanks to Dr. S.G. Gopalakrishna for raising his insights with us today. It was a very wonderful session, sir. I also would like to thank our principal, Dr. Srikanthamurthy K., Vice Principal, Dr. Harisha P., and Dean Academics, Dr. Jitendra Mungara, for joining us today. I would also like to extend my thanks to the organizing team, Dr. Mamta G, Dr. Yogesh, and Mr. Periswamy for putting together such a wonderful event. Lastly, I would like to thank our audience for joining us and helping us make this a very wonderful and successful event. One request is I would all request you to please fill up the feedback form within 15 minutes and any certificate will also be issued for this event.
Thank you, Bhavana, for your excellent comparing and handling of the overall show, the entire webinar. Thank you very much. I also thank Dr. Mamta and Dr. Yogisha for excellently organizing this and others who have joined, Dr. Srikanthamurthy and Dr. Jitendra and others who have also joined. I thank all of them. And one important point I would like to mention here, if there are any further queries, they can send in those queries. I think we'll try to answer them through mail or something like that. Help them out. Ultimately, every individual should be successful. And that is the motto.
Director, sir.
Yes.
This is an additional information because the audience, not only students and parents, it is all over India. Participation is there from Tamil Nadu, Andhra, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Delhi, Maharashtra. They are so happy. Everybody says, sir, with great example, you convinced this is the right time you are given a good information. And this participants, many of them are principals, professors, deans. We are very happy that the participation is very, very good, sir. And they are very happy about your presentation.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much for all the appreciations by each and every individual and for the participation. Every participant is important. For all that, I thank each and every participant in this webinar. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Director. Thank you, Director, sir.
Oh, Satyanarayan Raju. Yes, yes. Yes,
sir. A very inspiring presentation, sir.
Thank you. Thank
very
you.
Very rewarding. Thank you, sir. Thanks for presenting very nicely.
No, ultimately, what our motto is, it should help people. It should help individual. Yes. They should all think positively. If everybody thinks positively, there will be no problems.
Yes, sir.
So therefore, they should think positively in whatever situation. Adverse situation will come in everybody's life. But they should overcome that. Everybody should overcome that.
Yes, sir.
I just quoted the example of the facing the examination because many students are there, and therefore I said failure in an examination could be the situation, adverse situation. It could be a person in a family, father or mother or somebody, brother or sister, somebody may be ill.
Yes.
So that is an adverse situation where how they will face that and how they will take corrective steps.
Yes, sir.
That again is a problem. So yes. Therefore, or a business entity, for example, there they may have lost their orders.
Yes, sir.
So it could be anything like that.
We have given.
Somebody must have lost the job. Somebody must have lost the income.
Yes, sir.
With all that, they should overcome that. That is that. See, this is not the end of life. That's where the importance is. We should all. That's why we say I took the positive point. That's why, because everybody should think positively in any situation. Then success will be for that individual, for that group. Success will be there. This is, I am very confident, and therefore I am saying that. Everybody can be successful.
You have given enough examples from different walks of life. Really touching, sir.
Yes, yes. Thank
you. Thank you. Fantastic.
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Are we ending this now?
Yeah, sir, we can end this session. And
Bhavana, still that YouTube, you know, that feedback link is not appearing. Just
I've sent the feedback link. I've dropped the feedback link in the comment section. Please scroll up to look up for the link, and please fill the feedback form in 15 minutes.
No. YouTube still it is not appearing. Just to not see that.
Chat, sir.
Okay. Okay, sir, it is not appearing anymore. We will check it, sir, again.
Somehow, you try to overcome that. This is an adverse situation. People are not getting the link.
Yes.
You have to overcome that.
Again, you put, sir, no problem.
Yeah. You put the link straight, whatever it is. Yogesh, you please put the link directly so that people can understand and give the feedback. If they give the feedback, number one, they also feel better that they have understood this. Second one is they get the e-certificate for having participated in this, which may be of use to them at some point of time, particularly the students.
We'll look up and see what we can do about it.
Bhavana, wish you all the best. Thank you very much for comparing and doing an excellent job.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.